Joining me on GCS today is Christine Lutz. She is a kindergarten teacher at Sherwood Elementary School and recently honored by Fox 46 in Charlotte as a teacher getting results. Thank you for being with us on GCS today.
Thank you for having me.
Now, what is it like to be honored by Fox 46 in Charlotte as a teacher getting results?
Well, it has been a very surreal experience. It is bigger than I thought it was going to be, and it has been very meaningful, not just to me. At first I thought, why me? And then I thought, well, why not me? But it's not just me, it's our profession. And as educators, you know, we know amongst ourselves what we do and the meaning of our work, and it's a work of heart, and we know how hard we work. And sometimes outside of the education field, people don't realize that. But to be spotlighted in that way just made others see that it's such a valuable profession. And so I'm glad they brought attention to our field of education.
Now, several weeks ago, they came over to visit in your classroom, and they did a segment that aired on their 10 o'clock newscast, and then the following morning, they invited you over, and you were on their morning show. What was that experience like?
That was really interesting. I had never been in a television studio, so to see how all that works was very interesting. It was very humbling to be chosen, and I feel like I'm a spokesperson for many because our school and our county has so many talented teachers. It could have been any number of teachers. So I just hope that I did all of us proud.
Now, you have kindergartners. What makes your classroom special?
The children, obviously. They come every day with a love for learning, with smiles, with joy in their heart. They're excited. They're just like a new box to open every day. There's a lot of challenges, but we have a lot of fun. We work hard. We play hard. And it's just a joy to teach them because they have a natural curiosity and a desire to learn. And they're just little sponges and they soak it up. And it's just a wonderful thing to see every day.
Now, you have a Friday tradition in your class before the children go home. Tell us about that.
I started that this year doing the happy dance. It's this, you know, the happy song, and we pull it up with the Minions version. And it's just our time of day when we just kind of cut loose, and it's just pure fun and joy and silly, and we dance and show off our moves. I want the children to know that happiness is a choice, and no matter what type of day they've had, no matter what's going on, you know, if it's been a stressful week, testing week, if they're tired, if they're not feeling well, I just want them to have a few minutes just to be happy. I want them to realize that, you know, over the weekend while we are apart, that they're still thought about, that they're loved, that they're missed. I want them to be happy all weekend long and look forward to coming back to school. I also, usually we invite a guest dancer in. So it's someone from around the school. We've had itinerant teachers, support staff, other grade level teachers. And so they come in and they don't know why they're coming in. Our administrators have come in. And so they're a little surprised. Now they kind of know what's going on. But at the beginning, they did not know. So they would come in and they would just start moving with us, and you would just see the smile on their face. And so I want the kids to realize that what they do has an effect on others, and that when they make others happy, that those people will go out and share their joy, and it will just multiply. So a pay it forward kind of message.
Now, I know that you had the news anchor that came to your classroom. She was part of the happy dance.
Yes.
As well. You made a good point during the interviews with the TV station that you want students to be happy, but also happy about school, and a message that you teach them to at a very young age, that school is a happy place, that you hope that message carries through on to middle school and to high school.
Yes, I think it's really important for our kids today. They live in a very different world, and they get a lot of messages, and I want it to be very clear to them that school is a place where they are safe, where they are loved, where they can be happy, that they are supported, that there's many people outside of our classroom that care about them and want the best for them. I want them to realize from this very early age, their first experience with school, that this is a place they want to be.
What do you love about teaching?
The children, again, number one. The biggest thing I love is just seeing them grow from where they come in. And yesterday on the news, Paige had spoke about all the different levels. And I was really impressed that she realized that. A lot of people don't. When they come to us in kindergarten, there are so many different abilities and experiences they've had prior to that that puts them at so many different places. And it's a real challenge to meet every one of them where they are and move them forward. So it's constantly coming up with new tricks and, you know, figuring out how to help this one and that one and lots of change. But at the end of the day and then at the end of the month and at the end of the year, just seeing how they've bloomed, it's a wonderful feeling.
It is very obvious that you are getting results in your classroom at Sherwood Elementary School. We congratulate you on being recognized by Channel 46 in Charlotte, and we appreciate everything you do for your students and for us here in Gaston County Schools. And we appreciate you being here on today's edition of GCS Today.
Well, thank you. It was a pleasure to be here.